Hi, Suburban family and friends. It's our 28th day of the Bible reading plan. And today, as I was reading through the passage, well, several of the passages, it reminded me of a memory from 41 years ago when I was standing in my bedroom looking out the window and I was asking questions like, are you really real, God? Who are you? Do you really hear me? And what's this thing about people who say that they're Christians, but their behavior doesn't seem to really look like it? And so I had so many questions and I didn't know who to ask. So I actually reached out to a Christian radio station and I got a letter back, which was great. And I still have that letter. So I wanted to read one of the paragraphs from that. It's dated September 7th, 1977. Carrie, we are very glad to know that you are thinking seriously about your relationship with God and what your commitment to Christ should be. God always honors a seeking, asking mind, and we think the sorts of questions you are asking will help you to deepen and strengthen your faith. And so I went through this process for several months of just asking these questions. And so Romans 6, 1 through 11 from the reading plan today really sparked that memory and the question. So let me read that the first couple of sentences there. Well then, should we keep on sinning so that God can show us more and more of his wonderful grace? Of course not. Since we have died to sin, how can we continue to live in it? And so I was just thinking through that, and it reminded me also of recently I heard a speaker at a workshop talk about how in the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke, there's really no mention directly of God loving us. There is in the Gospel of John, but in Matthew, Mark, and Luke, there's all this mention of God loving his son. So it's a beautiful picture of a father-son relationship. And it's because of what Jesus did on the cross that we can actually be seen by God as his through his son. And so that's that connection, being with him, is what makes it possible for us even to receive the gift of salvation. And so I'm going to read some more of this passage from Romans, and I'm going to emphasize some of the words, because anytime we hear this language of with him or in him or through him, it's this really inclusive language and it's invitational. And so let me just read some of those. Have you forgotten that when we were joined with Christ in baptism, we joined him in his death? For we died and were buried with Christ by baptism. Since we have been united with him in his death, we also will be raised to life as he was. We know that our old sinful selves were crucified with Christ so that sin might lose its power in our lives. We are no longer slaves to sin. For when we died with Christ, we were set free from the power of sin. And since we died with Christ, we know we will also live with him. So you can hear that super strong through this whole passage. And then it's because of that, that's the whole foundation of how we can then go and do behaviors that are loving and gracious and forgiving and patient and all of that. But it's having that foundation of being with him first that helps us to do that. And I love that picture. And then so here's another paragraph from that letter that I got from the radio station. The very last paragraph says, God does love us as we are, but remember that God knows all of what we are, and that includes our potential, our possibilities. Therefore, as he loves us, he also calls us to grow, to become more of what he has put in us to be. Accepting God's love and knowing that he accepts us doesn't mean that we complacently fold our hands and say, well, that's how I am. Rather, we work to rid ourselves of the sin which blocks our relationship with him, and we try to do the thing which we know will enhance our fellowship with him. In that way, we experience his love and acceptance as we are, even while we are on our way to becoming that much more of what he has planned for us. And that's really what the full and free life is all about. It's becoming more like Jesus because he is with us. And so Colossians 3 in today's reading plan is one of my favorite passages. I'm going to kind of go through verse 17 and I'm going to read it in the Message. There's a picture in here that I really want to leave us with. And so it starts out, so if you're serious about living this new resurrection life with Christ, act like it. Pursue the things over which Christ presides. Your old life is dead. Your new life, which is your real life, even though invisible to spectators, is with Christ in God. He is your life. And that means killing off everything connected with that way of death. And there's a whole list of things that they're encouraging you to kill off there. You're done with that old life. And here's the picture. It's like a filthy set of ill-fitting clothes you've stripped off and put in the fire. Now you're dressed in a new wardrobe. Every item of your new way of life is custom made by the Creator with his label on it. All the old fashions are now obsolete. So chosen by God for this new life of love, dress in the wardrobe God picked out for you. Compassion, kindness, humility, quiet strength, discipline. Be even-tempered, content with second place, quick to forgive an offense. Forgive as quickly and completely as the Master forgave you. And regardless of what else you put on, wear love. It's your basic all-purpose garment. Never be without it. So when I think about celebrating 42 years of being with the Savior, which will be 42 years next week, I just think about this whole idea of us putting on this garment of love and all of these pieces, all because of what he did with us and because we made that decision to be with him. So I think our prayer point is really to be asking, what kind of a garment are we wearing today? Are we really wearing that garment where we're really with him? Have a good day.